transpose of a matrix. First we will see what is the transpose of a matrix. Then we will study the properties of transpose operation of a matrix, and we will study these properties with the help of examples. So let's get started. Coming to the definition, what is transpose of a matrix? The new matrix which is obtained from a given matrix, suppose we take a matrix A. When we interchange the rows of matrix A by columns, the new matrix thus obtained is called the transpose of that particular matrix A, and it is denoted by AT. Right? So the new matrix obtained from a given matrix A by interchanging its rows into columns or columns into rows is called transpose of a matrix A, and it is denoted by AT. If A is a matrix of order M cross N, we suppose we have a matrix A, A, B, C, D. And it has the order M cross N. So when we take the transpose of a matrix, which is obtained when we change the rows into columns, now the order of the new matrix after taking the transpose is N cross M. And if A is a square matrix of order N, then A transpose is also a square matrix of order N. Okay, coming to the properties of transpose operation of a matrix. The first one we have is A transpose whole transpose. This is equals to A for any matrix A. Let's check it by example. See, first we took the transpose A transpose, so changing the rows into columns. This is row, changing it into column. 104, writing it in column. 352, writing it in column. Then again taking the transpose of this matrix, writing this row into column, second row into column, and third row into column, and the matrix thus obtained, this is equals to A. So it means A transpose whole transpose is equals to A itself. Property number two. So property number two we have is A plus B whole transpose. This is equals to A transpose plus B transpose if A and B have the same order. Okay, so now we will take an example of 2 cross 2 matrix. We suppose A to be equals to 1, 4, 6, 7 and B, this is equals to 3, 7, 5, 9. Right? So first we will solve the left hand side, A plus B whole transpose. So first we will add A plus B. This is equals to 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 plus 7 11, 6 plus 5 11, and 9 plus 7 is 16. So now we will take the transpose A plus B whole transpose. This is equals to changing the rows into columns, 4, 11, and changing this row into column, we have 11, 16. So this is the left hand side. Now we will solve the right hand side. It says A transpose plus B transpose. So first we will take the transpose of matrix A, which is equals to, changing the rows into columns, we have 1, 4, 6, 7, and taking the transpose of B, 3, 7, 5, 9. Now we will add these terms, A transpose plus B transpose, this is equals to 1 plus 3, 6 plus 5, 4 plus 7, and 7 plus 9. So this is equals to 1 plus 3 is 4, 6 plus 5 is 11, 4 plus 7 is 11, and 9 plus 7 is 16. Right? This means the above result is proved that A plus B whole matrix is equals to A transpose plus B transpose if A and B have the same order. The third one property of a transpose operation of a matrix is that AB whole transpose, this is equals to B transpose A transpose if AB can be performed. Okay, again we will take the example of a 2 cross 2 matrix. We suppose the matrix A to be equals to 2, 4, 6, 8 and matrix B 1, 3, 5, 9. So first we will take the left hand side of the equation, which is AB whole transpose. So for that purpose, first we will multiply the matrix A and B. So how to multiply a 2 cross 2 matrix? Multiply the rows, this one, with the column. Right? So we have 2 into 1 plus 4 into 5. Now multiply the same row with the next column and we have 2 into 3 and 4 into 9. Next what we will do is multiply the second row with the first column 6 1 times and 8 5 times. Clear? Now multiply the same row with the second column 6 into 3 times plus 8 into 9 times. So 2 1 times 2 plus 4 5 times is 20. 2 3 times is 6 plus 9 4 times is 36. 6 1 times 6 plus 8 5 times is 40. 6 3 times is 18 plus 8 9 times is 72. So 2 plus 20 is 22. 36 plus 6 is 42. 40 plus 6 is 46 and 18 plus 72 is 90. So this is AB, right? So now taking the transpose, and changing the rows into column, we have 22, 42 and 46. 90. So this is AB whole transpose. Now we will solve the right hand side of the equation, which is B transpose A transpose. So first we will take the transpose of B, which is equals to 1, 3, 5, 9. ए ट्रांसपोज इज इक्वल्स टू 2, 4, 6, 8. नाउ वी विल मल्टीप्लाई दीज टू मैट्रिसेस, बी ट्रांसपोज ए ट्रांसपोज. And 8. So as I already taught you the method of multiplying two matrices, now I will write the answer directly. 1 2 times is 2 plus 5 4 times is 20. Now 1 6 times is 6 plus 5 8 times is 40. 3 2 times is 6 plus 9 4 times is 36. 3 6 times is 18 plus 9 8 times is 72. So this is equals to 22, 6 plus 40, 46, 36 plus 6, 42, and 18 plus 72, this is equals to 90. So this matrix is 22, 46, 42 and 90. So it means AB whole transpose is equals to B transpose A transpose. Now discussing the fourth property. Okay, so this property says KA whole transpose, this is equals to K A transpose for any matrix A where K is a scalar. So in this case, let we take A to be a general matrix A, B, C, D. Okay, so now solving the left hand side of the equation, first we will multiply K, which is a scalar, with the matrix A. Like this. So now multiplying K with all the entries of the matrix, we have KA, KB, KC and KD. So this is, we have KA. Taking the transpose of the matrix, changing the rows into column, we have KA, KB, KC, KD. So this is the left hand side. Now solving for the right hand side of the equation, first we will take the transpose of A and then we will multiply a scalar K with it. So A transpose is equals to AB C D, right? Now we will multiply a scalar K with it. So this is equals to K, and now we will multiply a scalar K with this matrix, and we have KA, KC, KB and KD. So this is equals to this one matrix. So we have KA whole transpose, this is equals to A transpose K.